Merseyside police have been carrying out an investigation involving a significant link to Liverpool City Council. Last year, this led to arrests on suspicion of fraud, bribery, corruption, misconduct in public office, and witness intimidation. On the 17th of December, I informed the House that additionally, persuasive evidence had been presented to me regarding the Council's planning, highways, regeneration, property management functions, and associated audit and governance arrangements. In light of that evidence, I commissioned Max Caller to conduct a best value inspection of the Council. It paints a deeply concerning picture of mismanagement, the breakdown of scrutiny and accountability, a dysfunctional culture putting the spending of public funds at risk and undermining the city's economic development. Expressed in formal terms, I'm satisfied that the Council is failing to comply with its best value duty. Therefore, I need to consider exercising my powers of intervention to secure compliance with the duty. To that end, in line with the procedures laid down in the Local Government Act 1999, I'm writing today to the Council asking them to make representations, both on the inspector's report and on a proposed intervention package. This package is centred on putting in place commissioners who I will appoint to exercise certain and limited functions of the Council as required for a minimum of 3 years. I hope and expect Liverpool City Council to take the lead in this path to improvement. However, given the gravity of the inspection findings, I must consider what would happen if the Council fails to deliver the necessary changes at the necessary speed. I'm consequently proposing to direct the transfer of all executive functions associated with regeneration, highways, and property management at the authority to the commissioners. These are for use should the council not satisfy the commissioners in their improvement processes. As the son and grandson of Liverpudlians, I know Liverpool, and I appreciate the sense of humour, the loyalty and the warmth of its residents. I also understand the city's independent spirit, and so I'm clear that we are embarking on a partnership to mend a politics that for too long has been rooted in a pervasive and rotten culture. I'm hopeful that this is the start of a new chapter for Liverpool City Council, because in all of this, it is the residents of Liverpool who are being let down, whose regeneration is being undermined, whose taxpayers' money is being wasted, and whose city is being besmirched rather than cited with municipal pride.